In this video, we are going to see how to construct the multiplication table for the elements of GF 2 to the power 3. One thing to be noted over here is, irrespective of what polynomial we are using to construct the GF 2 to the power 3, the multiplication table remains the same. And over here also, we do not require the polynomial representation of these field elements. So now let us see. Once again, here are the elements 0 to alpha to the power 6, over here also 0 to alpha to the power 6. If we multiply any element by 0, we get 0. So the first row is all zeros. By similar reasoning, the first column is also all zeros. If we multiply any element by 1, we get back the element itself. So that is how we get the second row and the second column. Now the third row. Alpha into alpha, that is alpha square. Alpha into alpha cube, we have alpha to the power 4. Alpha into alpha to the power 4 is alpha to the power 5. Alpha into alpha to the power 5 is alpha to the power 6. Next, alpha into alpha to the power 6, that is alpha to the power 7. Alpha to the power 7 is 1 for GF 2 to the power 3. So we have written 1 over here. Similarly, if you take a look at this element, alpha square into alpha to the power 6, that is alpha to the power 8, which is alpha into alpha to the power 7. So since alpha to the power 7 is 1, we get alpha over here. So this is how we can construct the multiplication table. And once wherever we have any power of alpha that is greater than 6, we simply substitute it using the equation alpha to the power 7 is equal to 1. We can see over here alpha to the power 6 into alpha to the power 6. That is supposed to be alpha to the power 12, which can be written as alpha to the power 7 into alpha to the power 5. Since alpha to the power 7 is 1, so we get the result as alpha to the power 5 over here. And once again, we can see that all the elements that we obtained in this table, they belong to the GF 2 to the power 3. So this GF 2 to the power 3 is closed with respect to the multiplication operation also.